kind of appealing to everybody.
For Adam Lambert and Chris Allen, Michaels is a musical influence whose achievements they will always look to in admiration and amazement.
I feel like Michael Jackson has changed music completely when he started and everything that he did. And I think that it's evident in almost everything that everyone does.
Michael was a genius at inventing himself, inventing music, inventing imagery. He will be remembered for inspiring countless other artists. He will always be loved and adored on the radio, on the CD, and on vinyl, wherever you have him.
And when we come back, we move from the music to the moves. Michael Jackson as the master who taught millions how to dance. Stay with us. You are looking at a live shot of the Hollywood Walk of Fame on Hollywood Boulevard in Los Angeles. Thousands of fans have been waiting in line patiently for their chance to file past Michael Jackson's star. They have been waiting all day long, fans, to get their chance to pay their respects. Not only was Michael Jackson an incredible musician, he was a magician of dance. His incredible moves now live forever in dance videos that reinvented the genre. And that's what a generation of younger artists grew up watching and imitating. Here's Deborah Roberts.
Where did it come from? The steps, unlike anything ever witnessed.
There's an expression about trying to capture lightning in a bottle. Whenever you saw Michael Jackson on stage, that's what it was like. It was like that thunderstorm that came out, lightning and thunder and power, and then it would all calm down, and then you could see better. And then he was smooth and quiet like the gentle rain. He was all of that. He was a force of nature, and to see him on the stage was like an experience I cannot describe. If you didn't ever see him, then you missed it.
Choreographer to the stars, Debbie Allen, has seen them all, but no one like her longtime friend, Michael.
In dance, it's what we sit and train for, we try to teach. You either have this or you don't. Michael danced with such a sharpness. He was so clean, he was so, his precision was beyond. And this is a true master. Michael practiced, Michael trained. Michael continued to try to expand his dance vocabulary. That was our relationship. He was always coming up to my house and wanted me to teach him something that he might not know. I'm like, child, you know everything, stop it. Talking about he wanted to turn like Baryshnikov. I said, child, you turn better than Baryshnikov, leave me alone.
Director Kenny Ortega was working with Michael on his comeback tour.
When Michael got into the zone, it was Michael, as we all have known him and have all fallen in love with, you know, that incredible entertainer, the perfect timing and know-how, and just, you know, sparking, you know, electric, electricity flying off of him, inspiring everyone around him, the dancers, the singers, the orchestra, and every creative person, you know, involved in the project.
Show me what you do. Teach me.
In the documentary Living with Michael Jackson, he told Martin Bashir it's hard to pinpoint where it all began.
Did somebody teach you to do that?
No, you can't teach that. You can't teach it. It has to come from inside. It's a gift, you know.
At this Grammy Award ceremony, Jackson admitted he did have his influences.
I remember when we were little, I used to ask her to be Ginger Rogers while I was Fred Astaire.
But he took it somewhere all his own. Martin Scorsese directed the video Bad and says watching Jackson was like watching Quicksilver in motion.
What was it about him as a dancer? What was that thing?
Each time just going in, and he really went in. And as a dancer, as a good one, you want to go in and focus your energy, and he could actually really focus on a dime. Who's
bad? That's Desmond Richardson to the right with Michael in that video. He says Jackson revolutionized the world of dance.
It just opened our eyes, like, wow, we don't have to stay compartmentalized in this, you know, I'm only doing ballet, or I'm only doing jazz, or I'm only, you know, popping, or it can be all together.
And nowhere was it more apparent than in that trademark moonwalk. It took the country by storm. Jackson first debuted on the Motown 25th anniversary special back in 1983.
I just remember phones ringing immediately after he did that, you know, trying to get to the phone. Did you just say what happened? You know, because I had never seen anything like that. You could feel the roar of the audience, and I know in my own living room, you know, my roommate and I just screamed, you know, and you just want to play it again and again and again. And I mean, that's the kind of transcendent figure he was, you know, to create this kind of excitement.
And from that moment on, he became a teacher to dancers everywhere, from Paula Abdul.
What did you learn from him? Anything?
Oh my gosh. You never let anyone see you sweat. And when you perform, you give everything that you have, every pore of your body, everything that spills out is left on that stage. And the commitment, and it's the rehearsal. The drive that guy had was unparalleled. I've never seen anyone work that hard.
And from that moment on, he became a teacher to dancers everywhere, from Paula Abdul to pop stars all over, like Justin Timberlake, Usher, and Ne-Yo.
Sort of embrace the inspiration of Michael and take it to a whole nother level. So we're not just looking at dance steps and some good tunes. We're looking at a whole show, and that's what Michael was all about, bringing everything together and making that show pop. And you're just like mesmerized when you're watching a concert.
What does today feel like for you?
It hurts. You know, you just, like that song, never can say goodbye. You know, we just can't say goodbye to him. So I'm just gonna put it, you know, we're gonna all be living with this big hole in our hearts. That's how it's going to be.
So many people tonight saying goodbye. And when we come back, the very latest on the investigation into the death of Michael Jackson. Stay with us. Looking at a live shot tonight at the Apollo Theater in Harlem, where Michael Jackson performed with his brothers as a boy. And it's an impromptu celebration of his life by fans who have gathered outside, many of them dressed up in Michael Jackson costumes, dancing to his music. And even tonight, as we salute the man and his music, real questions remain about what killed Michael Jackson. For the very latest on the investigation, starting with the 911 call that signaled the beginning of the end, here is Jim Avila.
What is your emergency?
Yes, sir. I need an ambulance as soon as possible, sir.
12:21 West Coast time, and the caller at Carrollwood Drive in Los Angeles is in a panic.
We have a gentleman here that needs help, and he's not breathing yet. He's not breathing, and we're trying to pump him, but he's not
okay.
Breathing, sir.
Okay, how old is he?
He's 50 years old, sir.
50, okay. He's unconscious, he's not breathing?
Yes, he's not breathing, sir.
Okay, and he's not conscious either?
No, he's not conscious, sir.
Okay.
And while the caller is careful not to...